Wonder how our team is doing against this enemy. We must work hard against this enemy. Matter of fact, let me see how my team is doing. Hello? Well, I expect to get my briefing now.
Greetings, Master.
Well, how's it been going with your assignment? Have you been keeping our patient in line with our plan? Have you been doing your job?
Well, yes, Master. I've done what you requested and more. Good. And I've convinced them that, you know, our enemy,
the name we can't speak of, doesn't exist.
Good.
And, well, everything he sees could be explained in science.
Science? Well, make sure you're not using real science, because real science leads to questions, and questions leads to answers, and that's what we can't afford to have them questioning. So next time you use something crafty like that, make sure you don't give out too much that he ends up questioning it.
Yes, Master, but how do I do that again?
Do I need to teach you everything all over again? Man, go ahead. What is our strategy? Our strategy is to mix what's true with a lie. Therefore, they think they're walking in truth, but deny its power. So I'm gonna say this for the last time, Mango Head. Make sure he doesn't question his beliefs. Now you go and check on him and come back to me soon.
Yes, Master.
This fool better not mess this up. Matter of fact, let me see how my other messenger is doing with their job.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Today we're going to study from the book of James. Please turn in your Bibles with me to James chapter 1.
Yes, Master.
Well, how's it been going with our patient? You've been doing your job?
Yes, Master. I am. And then more.
Well, keep me up to date.
Well, I'm actually in church right now, and there are lots of people around me. And the speaker's hyping up the name we can't speak of. He's saying all the stuff about him.
Uh-huh.
And the patient was listening really hard. I was so scared that he was buying into it, so I started to distract him. I tried to throw some thoughts in his head about the things that he did the night before. And Master started to fall for it. He soon was completely distracted.
Huh?
Though he was there physically, he wasn't there mentally.
What about now? What's going on now?
Well, this is the beginning of the speaker's lecture about the name we can't speak of. But don't worry, our patient is distracted.
Well, keep me up to date. Remember, we cannot afford to let this lecture that they're giving at this church grab his attention. We cannot afford to have him questioning, because questioning leads to wanting to know an answer. But here's the trick. Make sure he believes that he's got all the answers. Oh, and don't forget our strategy. Mix what's true with a lie. Therefore, it ends up being a lie. Keep me up to date.
I will, Master.
Thank you. and I messed this up.
Greetings, Master.
What, man? Go ahead. Did you lose our patient? Did you lose him to our enemy?
No, I
didn't.
Well, good.
But he did get curious.
What? How? What were you doing? I told you to convince him that our enemy doesn't exist. I told you to make him believe in science. Not real science, but science.
I know. It's just, well, something happened.
What happened?
Well, he was on a bus coming from work.
You know, to where his car was parked.
That's his usual schedule.
And, well, the bus driver was being stupid.
Good.
And he was driving all crazy.
Good.
And, well, he ended up hitting a car.
Well, good.
And almost everyone on the bus were left with minor injuries.
Even better.
And
our patient was standing next to this young lady.
And before it happened, she called out, you know, the name we can't speak of. And everyone on the bus went to the driver and they started saying, you know,
words that you like.
Good.
And they started yelling at him and making him feel, you know, the way you like him to feel.
Good.
And our patient was just standing next to this bus driver. And suddenly, the girl who used the word we can't speak of, she goes up to the bus driver and she starts talking to him. She hugs him. She gives him tissues for his tears. And she even forgave him.
And she asked if he needed anything. And our patient was standing there and he saw all of this.
Oh, no.
And, well, our patient went towards this young lady.
Did you try to stop him? Did you try to distract him? Did you?
Well, he started asking her questions.
What questions?
Well,
I couldn't hear her because the young lady had the blood of, you know, the name we can't speak of, all over her, and I couldn't get near her.
What happened then?
Well, after she left, our patient was convinced that there was something special about this girl. And I tried to convince him that she was just a confused soul.
She sure is.
But I'm scared. I'm scared he was happy that he met her. And I'm sorry, Master. I'm sorry, but he just seemed really happy.
I'm not worried about happy. I am not worried about his or their happiness.
Really?
No. Do you know what the root word for happiness is mango?
No.
It is happen. People get happy when things happen. But there are two things that happen. Good things happen and bad things happen. And so you get happy when things happen. That's good. And then when bad things happen, you get angry, you get upset, you get irritated. See, happiness is conditional. I wish all our patients were just happy. I am not.